throwing a flashbang.
Fire in the hole. Throwing grenade.
Fog.
Deploying flashbang. Out. Throwing smoke. Grenade out.
Gary, that's a problem. All he needs to do is stop the plant now. JDM switched across. He's got himself the Galil. He has to find the killer. Edward's just going to run and hide. He's picked himself up a MAC-10. JDM's in trouble. Is he going to stick the plant in? He's left it too late. Oh, he's still got the kill, though. Edward just had to hide. What? That was all he needed. I don't know. I didn't hear whether there was an actual fake plant coming in there.
No, I think he went for it. I think he just stopping in that situation when the time's so low. You would just automatically assume the plant is to be coming in. But that was such a risky play from JDM not to go for the plant then. It almost having to guarantee himself the kill, but he pulls it off, and what a round it was there, and gets him straight back into the game. Four rifles in hand now, but that was too close for comfort for them. Navi, though, going to be a little bit disappointed they didn't convert that one to a victory, but here we go then, third round underway.
Definitely would have hurt them economically as well. That's why we're seeing Galils and, of course, JDM back on that P250. Had that scout originally. Now, how are they going to play this? Are they going to switch things up? We saw a lot of tried and tested coming out from Na'Vi yesterday. Let's see if CLG do the same thing. Try and stick with what works. This time it looks like they are stacking up for a bit of an A site hit. You can see it is just sees the one man over there. Oh, Hazed. In that little troublesome peek around the corner.
Yeah,
finds
strike
Jamie's
comes
head.
In though. They're waiting for that B strike to come in, but not going to come to anything this time. The terrorists should make their way into the air bomb site now.
They managed to get around the back of C's. This is a little worrying. And that's going to be cut. They will spin around behind him. Tarek's going to get Guardian cleanly there. Zeus also should drop, but he manages to come out on top with the USPS. And now Zeus and Edward with next to no health left will get picked off. And CLG do close out that third round comfortably in the end.
So, yep, perfect start for CLG. We talked about them not favouring this map too much and they're going to struggle. But Na'Vi having quite a lot of discipline this time. They didn't force the issue, didn't go into it with full buys and trying to buy armour, etc. So they go into this with five rifles and a decent set of utility as well. So it'll be interesting to see how this round goes down. We do see the AWP on JDM. That could be very important. He's got a decent B spawn as well. So he's got two options now. Does he take it to the upper area and try and go straight for that pick? And it looks like that's exactly what he'll be doing. And whether the firefrack here will be yet to be seen.
Drop. Let's see if he can pop around there. Hayes does manage to drop straight down, gets that one. Remember, this is the rifles for Na'Vi. They have to start trying to lock something down here. Edward in a tricky position on platform while he's flashed out there. Does manage to find himself one, though. But that's going to be quickly answered. And Flamey getting the good crossfire on him. Gives him a great position. Hayes going down. JDM all alone. This AWP investment that he's finally gone towards is not going to pay off here. Grenade's coming flooded, thinking fast once again, flashing him out. They know exactly where he is. Yep. Now he has to be worried about the flank trying to hold that gun.
Yeah, so that's all he can do now, try and save the AWP. It seems like CLG got a bit excited that round, and they had the prospect of getting in there and getting the first hit, but it didn't seem to happen for them. So they got into the drop down area, and then all of a sudden they're peeking one by one, running into the bomb site, making sure that the fractures weren't going in their favor whatsoever. Now they clean up and get their first round on the board.
Yeah, and JDM's just trying to hang on to this rifle. He's got a long time, though, to keep it. But for Na'Vi themselves, their economy is not exactly fantastic, so I'd be surprised if they hunt this down too aggressively. They're just going to sit and wait it out. JDM, with 25 seconds on the board, still actually has it in him to maybe do something here. That drop would have been heard. Flamey heard that straight away, so he's just going to line himself up there. But the bomb just around the corner, nicely done. Flamey spends his time well, pops through the window and gets the kill.
So this is where things get interesting now, because Flamey has picked up the AWP, and we know who that's going to. Guardian, obviously contending right now for the world's best AWP player. We know how influential he can be on this map. But CLG, obviously going into an eco here. They've got the tech lines coming out. They have got one smoke on Kyler as well, so suggesting they may do something maybe a little bit more methodical. FNS picked up a smoke as well, so possibly a smoke execution on the side, with purely with the target to be get the bomb down and see what they can do with it then.
Let's see where Cutler and FNS do take this. Maybe try and burst through on them, try and use speed to their advantage.
So that information Guardian is just gathered by peeking top and middle there. He can call now the team to rotate back to B and just wait for the execution. Now that's a great bit of intel for him, and C's also pushing top and middle, just confirming that.
Yeah, Guardian, you can see, is way out in long A, so he has it completely covered off back there. So they're fully committed and expecting this to come. There's the smoke bouncing through. That's going to lock off double door three. Doesn't matter, they're already through. Everybody's already in on site. Look at Zeus up close and personal, ready to pop heads the second they come around the corner. But now they're going to track on. They've gone through the window and actually managed to sneak on through. This is a great little fake they've managed to pull off here, and just completely caught them all in B site and rushed straight through A. They are home free right now, and it's down to Na'Vi for the retake.
Yeah, lovely bit of play there. Na'Vi didn't see this coming whatsoever, and this connector contention is going to be huge now. Flamey taking down Hayes, but it's a big retake in order for Na'Vi.
Cutler with the M4. That's the kill they needed, and that may well cause some problems. FNS trying to get around the side. Tarek tucked in. That's going to work out well. And his eco gone horrifically wrong for Na'Vi. They're going to get caught out. FNS makes it pay. And that was a problem for Na'Vi. Now, if you'd have read some of the interviews that Guardian came out with recently, he talked about how they had really had a lot of problems. A, with fast play, which that wasn't so much of, but more about retakes. They've really struggled to retake sites together as a team, and that showed.
Well, the fact that Na'Vi are letting them to get into drop down and go through connector like that without any sort of confrontation whatsoever is questionable in itself, and that's such a huge round to lose after winning the first gun round and losing the subsequent round. You look at their money right now, they're going to be looking down the barrel of going down 5-1 on CLG on the T side of Cobble. This is massive.
Oh, wow. And as YNK just pointed out, for a Zeus gone for that head arm, he's only actually got 700 in the bank, so this round is lost. That's going to put him in real troubles for next round. That's
there he goes.
Something that, well, there he goes. That was an investment wasted.
That's a weird thing to do, to buy a head armor against AK-47s. What's the justification there? You don't need head armor against AKs. It's a one-shot kill anyway.
It has to have been a miss buy. It has to have been, but it's a bad miss buy nonetheless. And Na'Vi fans out there will be scratching their heads about it, while the rest of the team are starting to fall here. It's a good start for CLG. You know, we were questioning their T side, but so far they have opened up well. Tarek, this is one of the men that need to be on point for CLG. Was a little lackluster in the previous matchup, but was definitely on point against NIP yesterday.
Well, here we go then, the last man. It's going to be Edric. It's taken by Tarek, but we've always talked about CLG taking top teams right to the wire and never being able to close it out. They're in a current situation where they could be run away with this game. This is a huge round, and it looks like Na'Vi, after that horrendous buy from Zeus, they're going to be on and yet another eco here. I know that this is Na'Vi that can bounce back from this. It's not so much a CT-sided map as it's dwelled to be so far as the meta's developed, but they're in a very dangerous position. You can see some 5-7s coming out for them, but a round they definitely need to win, and they're not going to be stacking this time. Just a pretty standard setup for them.
Looks like the Mitro go a little aggressive over on A side. They're also going to stack up, and so they boost him in towards internet. So smokes and flashes coming through. He pushes on, does get himself double naded up, which takes him down to 7. You can see Flamey will finish that off. Good start for them, but you'd expect that when they set up with so many grenades. Now the problem is they have nothing left in their arsenal, just pistols to hold them up. But hitting that nade was right on Edward. Tarek will finish off and himself the double. Now Zeus trying to go the wrap around. I can see it is Guardian that's coming all the way through the back. He's the only man standing now, so they're going to be expecting this one. He's been missing for so long, almost certainly would come from behind.
One of those deadly Deagle players, as we've seen in previous tournaments, and that's exactly why the one bullet headshot onto FNS. And he has to make a decision. They have got decent bank accounts, so he can opt to try and make this round competitive at least.
Oh, that didn't quite bounce the direction he wanted it. JDM lines up his shot and does manage to make that AWP useful. Finally starting to get some use out of him. JDM a little rattled in the previous matchup, wasn't too happy with his performance overall, so I think this sort of start will be comfortable for him.
Oh, definitely, as a caller, Cutler is loving this so far. We can see now they have been favouring the B bombsite quite a lot here, so it wouldn't surprise me if they got the AWP to back a B perhaps, just to lock down that initial flag that COG been going for. But it's going to be Guardian looking for intel in middle once again. It's so good, and there's the opening pick. Now the team can just fall back and just relieve the pressure a little bit. It's such a crazy round as it's been in the past.
Can't push on through the smoke. Haste is going to burst through that. We'll get spotted quickly by Flamey though. And that was a double execution from him and Edward. They were very much on point, ready and waiting for the counter. Tarek just lurking around the side with Cutler with that bomb. It's all on JDM to get the rotate. That's what they're waiting for at the moment. Well, the rest of the team just get themselves set up. This is a good defense for Na'Vi this time around.
Yeah, all they need to do is hold back and force the T's to do something they don't want to. JDM still has got the AWP, so obviously going to rely on him, but that smoke plate there is going to lock them out for another 15 seconds, so they need to make the decision here. Looks like they maybe just got to go straight through it and see whether they can do the surprise frag here. Cutler setting himself up, and there goes the flashbangs of smoke coming out to the T side.
Oh, that didn't quite catch. I think they wanted to cut off. Flaming nonetheless still has clear vision. He was flashed up, but he can see just ducking and diving around the tree. He's already caused himself a nuisance on this spot, and it's working wonders for him. Switches across, gets that pistols P2000 on JDM, getting the little tags down, and Guardian chimes in to close things out and get Na'Vi the second round on the board on CT side.
Absolutely, that initial pick from Guardian instrumental in getting their first round win. That's what they needed, just to get the confidence back and bring the advantage in their favour to start of a round instead of chasing rounds, as it were. So you can see he still is going to keep the AWP. JDM will be answering back as well. As we said before, they really are favouring that B bomb site, but maybe a change of pace here now, as we can see two players making their way towards the top of middle. It's going to be Cutler as well, so potentially trying to shut down that early Guardian pick, but he's going to be in the stairwell this time.
Yeah, JDM ready and waiting for it as well. Look, he was lining up the shot, but Guardian's still looking for him. A couple of shots rattling through, but nothing really ringing true around Guardian. He's quite happy. The door taking all the punishment rather than himself. C's actually got a little tagged up there, so he's had to back up Ram and Haste once again, pushing through, going aggressive. Something we see Alphamaster doing almost every single round for Fnatic.
Typical NA stars, which Shroud will do quite a lot as well.
All seized in trouble here, mollied out the corner. That's going to take him yet lower, but you can see the drop being mollied out by Zeus. Good flash from Finesse will bite him out, but it's seemingly a little rotation. Still a little tit for tat here. Cutler, the in-game leader, will get shut down by seized, and that may well force COG to try and head in towards B-side.
Yeah, we can see the players now making their way in. Hayes going to be leading the charge. He gets taken by my Flamey, and that's going to be instrumental to stopping this push, and it seems like it's falling apart on the T side now.
This is a problem. Just the two remaining make it one. It's going to be JDM. Can he go huge here? He manages to get himself a double. Now, Guardian has seized, but he's only got 5 hit points, and he has to back away. He's got 25 seconds. This is going to be on the limit for this rotate. He looks like he's going to go through drop and window.
Yep.
Now, seized is only on 19 hit points if he's managed to find him. That drop taking him 5 hit points. Guardian. Oh, the timing. Yeah, Guardian just peeked around from the coop, and then it was a quick, easy shot.
I actually really like that from JDM, that movement there, going back to drop down. Had he have caught Guardian in the back there, could have been a really big round for them. But that's the third one on the board for Na'Vi now, bouncing back after that 6-1 deficit they took. And we can see, just looking at the money now, they have got enough to force a buy here, COG. But definitely with the bet they have of rounds, I would suggest just waiting this one out. Oh, as I say that, though, they actually are going to go for the last minute buy, as it was.
Okay, a bit of a force coming out here. Buy what you can for CLG. Now, they have got 6 rounds on the T side already, so they're going to be fairly happy with that, but more would be nice. And maybe they can try and catch Na'Vi off guard here, but those shots from Finesse will pretty much give away what they were trying.
Yeah, so they know the guns are in hand now, but they've been trying to work the upper platform area, see if the picks they can get early rounds. Hayes was getting those picks now, but it seems like Na'Vi finally have the utility to hold them out for as long as possible and not allow them to get that pick.
So they've struggled to get the last two rounds. They have taken it down to very close one-on-ones, one-on-twos, though. So maybe that's what they're thinking is here. Maybe they can just get a couple of rifles on the board. You can see the finesse. Those shots he's actually landing are just tagging onto that box that we've just found cover behind. They're going to pile down drop room. It's going to be Flamey they're going to find first, who just gets a good peek around the corner, but he didn't get any vision. Now he manages to find Tarik, but Tarik comes out on top in the duel. Edward lines himself up one on finesse and switches across to find Cutler. Now Zeus comes in. Support is arriving. Is he going to be expecting JDM in the corner? You bet your life he is, but he will manage to get gunned down. Seeds through window, closes it out, and now he gets themselves their fourth round on the board.
So Edward opting to go into the upper platform area now, and he really did go to town there, getting two huge frags, locking the tees down, not allowing them to get any sort of positional advantage there. So that was great play from him, a good read, and a great response to what the tees have been doing so far. And that force by now does put them onto almost a full eco. We'd have to take a look at the money. That's three in a row for them, so the loss bonus going in their favour. Next round, they should have been a pretty decent buy, but this round is going to be P250s, a flashbang as well, but they're going to opt to go towards mid-area, and it's going to be a very fast execution as well.
Let's see if it works out for them. Guardian is holding the angle, gets a good tag down onto Cutler, but didn't get the kill. He will do the second chance. Now he's just blocking the doorway for his teammates who are going to come through and support him. Hayes will get the spray down from Seized, and now it is a full defensive lockdown from Na'Vi. The Goose is very much out. They are well aware of this tactic, and pretty much it's a done deal. JDM just trying to pick things off from range. No kills were found. Na'Vi get themselves their fourth round running on the board. So 5-6.
Yeah, a very clean sweep for them that round. But yeah, four in a row. This is the Na'Vi we know. Obviously, the first five rounds not going in their favour is a horrible state of affairs for them. But now we see the full buy once again coming from CLG after a questionable course. By, I would say, but JDM back on the AWP, and it wouldn't surprise me if they didn't go back to that drop-down split. That seems what works for them. They seem to make sure they lock down Edward, who was boost up on the upper platform that time. But as soon as one goes down, JDM going to be leading the charge once again. The bomb will be making its way to B as well.
Hey, JDM not been able to really get any of those big opening picks that he's been looking for. Again, Smoke, as always, blocking off the angle. You can see Edward just lurking in the distance. The shot's very close to landing, but of course he is just tucked in behind that box. Meanwhile, the rest of the team lay in wait for the drop, but it's a double setup this time from Na'Vi at drop room. Looks like Telelights. Flame is on the outside. Yeah, Flame is on the outside, but there is Edward going down. So he was the man on platform. That's forced Guardian to actually rotate round. Now, are they overcommitting? Because Cutler and Tarik are yet to make the move towards B.
I think this is fine. The fact that the bomb's towards B as well, and they're showing no real presence. Those are just the guys waiting for the rotations. We can see C's there trying to get a pincer move here and see if he can find any information. There it is. He gets locked down and knows he can't go any further.
So Finesse has got to be careful. Guardian's got his eyes trained on that platform. The second Finesse is to come around, they have to get the smokes and flashes spot on here, CLG. Oh, Finesse, the opener, it will go straight down. Here they go, they're pushing straight through. Drop room, there is Finesse going straight down. It's Guardian and Zeus that chime in. Flamey's going to get himself another. Cutler will manage to respond, as well as JDM. Now it's a 2-on-1 in favour of CLG. Sees the man that was all the way over on A site, has to respond. That's a very good molly. Gets a glimpse on towards Cutler and a little tag. That nade is going to do a lot of damage. We'll take him down to 22, but he's going to get the plant in. Now, JDM, well, he had a clean shot there, and that was CLG picking up their seventh T-side round. This has been a very good start from them. Now, normally, CLG have a pretty solid CT side. Not too sure how it is on Cobble, but overall, across all maps, is usually how it stands.
That was actually really nice and disciplined from CLG, right? They got that initial pick, but instead of like just forcing the issue and getting into the bomb zone, trying to take advantage then, they waited for rotations. And an interesting reaction from Na'Vi as well. Edward's going to be picking up the auto sniper, but they just got to battle through that smoke on the upper platform. So this could be really interesting, but it seems like they're going to be opting towards all area then. Guardian gets to get taken down after taking a frag to Cutler.
Goes aggressive, yeah. That was a shot on Cutler, but it was quickly answered, and that actually puts them both in a 4v4. But as you mentioned, with that auto sniper set up, Edward actually sitting pretty deep with it. He's not going to go up on the platform, so he's going to sit and make sure he holds a fairly passive angle. Meanwhile, JDM is just holding true with Tarik over on A site. So this time, CLG slowing things down.
Yeah, so a definite change of pace for them here. They haven't shown much presence towards a long A area, but Guardian facing it, took one down. This works in their favour. 4-4 situation, especially on Cobble. The CT is going to be peeled out a little bit, and they'll be trying to work A. You can see them opting to go towards B. They're so convinced this is going to be another B side push, but the bomb is towards A. This could be great for CLG.
This is the first time I believe they've gone for that long A push. and maybe going successfully take it. Look at C's position. He's backed all the way down through connector. He's completely deep away from this one. A-site is wide open. Nobody in there. Finesse is selling a great fake right now to Navi. And why not? They've hit this site every single round. He's throwing just about everything out there. He's got one little flash to go. This is going to have to be a retake for Navi. There we go. Seized is going to get himself around the corner. Zeus will get one of Finesse, but Seized did go down on A-site, so that's given A-site across towards COG. Bomb plant will come in. JDM's laying that down. It's given Flamey time to get in position. Hayes, did he just catch a glimpse around the side? It doesn't matter. Zeus is backing up. His rear end in full sight of Hayes, and he manages to take the shot. Edward will go down. And again, Navi's retake, somewhat questionable. CLG had that one set up and really sold a great dummy.
Cuddler's doing some amazing mid-round calling here. This is really fantastic stuff from him. Reading the game perfectly, getting opening frags, and then just holding his team there. You saw Navi completely fell for it. FNS got himself in a fantastic position. He got into drop-down room, and it could have been a huge lurk. He got taken down, but it was enough just to keep the CTs there long enough while they got onto the bomb site. And we can see a pause coming in now, and obviously this is something Navi needs going into this.
It was Tarek that actually called.
Oh, really? I'd assumed it would be a tactical pause.
That's what I was thinking. It's actually working in their favor, but it's Tarek that's called it, so obviously something. I mean, that's an issue. They're 8-5 up. I haven't heard whether it's technical or whether it's. It would be very strange for CLG to call a pause, because it's given Navi, like you said, they are renowned for calling pauses, and this would be a great time for them.
Yeah, well, interesting enough now, we're looking down the barrel, 8-5 in favor of CLG on T side of Cobble, and Navi actually are on an eco this round. Just having a look at their cash, they've got about 2k average across the board. This is a dire straits, and they need to work out what they're going to do this round. Do they do the Hail Mary play, pull some scouts out, try and force it, and try and get as many rounds as possible? I'd say probably looking down to just taking the last round. It's going to be a frustrating decision for them. They'll go for some P250s here, but this is looking great for CLG. Like you said, we don't normally see them doing so well on the T side, but all signs point to yes right now for them.
Good little setup, good start. Pistol round win. Everything has gone CLG's way so far. It seemingly is stacked up against, and could we see potentially somewhat surprising a different American team reaching the quarterfinals, and more importantly, getting in towards that legendary status as they move through to the quarterfinals. It's a long way from over, though, as Navi are renowned for great comebacks. Guardian getting a little peek around the corner there. Tarek is the man that will extinguish his flame, though, as Edward comes around, and that's going to be a quick double for Tarek. JDM lining up the shot as Seize goes looking, and already three men down. Make that four as JDM takes down Seize. Flamey will drop, and Zeus is the last man standing. And they've really not done a great deal of damage throughout this round. They've took Hayes to 8 hit points, but that is it. They're not going to get a kill.
No, Tarek being very strong there in the long A area, going by himself, taking two huge frags, going to leave Zeus in a 5-on-1 situation. But yeah, like I said before, losing 9 rounds on the CT side of Cobble, we talk about it not really being a huge CT side of map these days, but losing the CT half is pretty questionable, especially against a team you outrank by about 10 places or so in the world ranking, so maybe even more. So this is amazing. I can't wait to see how this unfolds. Like you said, Navi, you can never count them out. They can always get back into these series, and they're renowned for doing it as well. That's the thing CLG have had this problem with going on. It's been something that's plagued them throughout their career, is not being able to finish games. We can see Zeus trying to do something a little bit cheeky towards the end, but it's not going to lead to much, I'm afraid. But just to finish my point, they don't seem to know how to close our games. If they don't close this one out, I think they're going to be pretty frustrated with themselves. They're going into this last round now. It's not going to be a full bite as such from a CT team. They'll have rifles, sure, but they're not going to have defuse kits. They're not going to have full sets of utility. So maybe they need to do something a little bit different here. They've been stacking B quite a lot. But that first round where Guardian got that information in the middle, just got that first pick, that's when they could just guarantee themselves a round. So it'd be interesting to see how they approach this last one now. 9-5 in favor of CLG, looking to take the 10th.
Maybe Cutler has figured out Navi's tactic. I don't know, maybe he's figured them out, because they were hitting B so hard and then switching things up again. JDM looking to try and get an open up, and Zeus going aggressive is exactly what they needed there, and that is a great response. Finesse does manage to get Edward down from platform, but Flamey was there to set him up, but it's an A-site hit once again. Seas is going to be pivotal in this one. He will manage to find Cutler. The bomb carrier goes down, and it looks to be a 9-6 half after all, as the rest of Navi get in position. JDM is going to line up the shots as he slowly creeps around looking for Zeus. It's going to be the first man he sees as he just gets a little glimpse around. Finesse with him now, and that flash is perfect, absolutely on point. That's going to take one down. JDM, the last man standing, as everybody moves into position. It will be a 9-6. Navi do rescue a little something. We'll see how vital that is moving into the second half.
Yeah, a little something is obviously key there, because the last round, big difference between 9-6 and 10-5. They get themselves the round they need at the end there after taking that choice to do the full eco before. So going into the T side now, they've got a big mountain to climb, but the T side pistol does favour the T's normally. We saw how CLG approached it, sending so many people into the drop down room. It means the CTs have to decide whether they challenge you and normally lose that battle. They let you retake the site, and it's such a hard decision. CT sides normally just have to hold back and hope they take the one shot kills of the P2000s, for example, but I don't see CLG doing that. I think they'll probably be doing something a little bit more aggressive, trying to get information somewhere else on the map, trying to get the first kill perhaps. But this is going to be a really exciting second half, and never count Navi out. They can always find a way back into these games.
Well, there is one statistic that rings true, and that is if Flamey performs, Navi tend to win games. And at the moment, I'm looking towards Navi's scoreboard, and he is at the top with 14 kills. So that is a good sign for Navi fans out there going in towards this T half. So we'll see whether he manages to start creating openings. Navi themselves, renowned for the slow play, and we're expecting that. I'm expecting CLG to load up on the smoke, especially over a B-site.
Yeah, I'd expect Navi to use the A-bomb site a lot more as well. Yeah. Just getting that teamwork towards the long A areas, utilizing middle together, and trying to pincer bomb sites in that way, instead of doing the classic, like the American style we saw so much from Cloud9 especially. They were going to the B-site, they utilize that one smoke, and they've got that player caliber to go through, use the AK, and Shroud seems to find a kill every single time. It took VP a while to lock that down, but it's a very different play style in Eastern Europe. We see VP kind of defined the A-bomb site as somewhere that's definitely viable, and you can go there almost every round. And that's why I'm saying Navi is probably the best place for them to go. They can utilize the Guardian AWP a lot more effectively in that area. So that's what I expect to see here. So whether CLG are going to be cottoning onto that early on is yet to be seen. But here we go then. The pistol goes underway. Let's have a look at the terrorist spy. So I think they'll be driven from pretty standard. Perhaps Flamey is going to be the raid boss, as it's been coined. Tech9 and armor for him. Two players with the smokes as well. So we could see almost a mirror strat here from what the CLG did. Get towards B, smoke off key choke points, and just bail into the side together.
It worked for CLG. Let's see if it works for Navi as we go into the second half. Ladies and gentlemen, this is ESL 1 Cologne. It is the group stage, and the winner will move through to the quarterfinals. They will face off against Envious, and that will of course be tomorrow in the Lanxess Arena. Don't forget to join us there. It is magnificent. Look at how deep Cutler's gone. Edward's going to find him. That will be a quick clean kill over at Long A, and that's going to open up A site completely.
That's what I talked about, trying to get that early information, but it's not going to work out for them.
Yeah, and that's going to be... Well, Finesse is going to try and get himself around the truck, but he's managed to get himself one tag down onto Zeus, but doesn't finish him the job. And now Guardian low, he's got to go for the reload. How did he get the reloaded? Finesse does manage to get himself a kill, but luckily the rest of Na'Vi finally get some responses. Tarek's still alive, guns down one, it's a 1-2. Now 50 health, with armor and a Tech-9, suddenly it's a 1-1. It's Guardian to the rescue for Na'Vi, and he will manage to nail the shot there. That was a little too close for comfort there, I feel, for Na'Vi.
I thought it was coming. Tarek seemed to be hitting everything that moved in that situation. Came down to a one-on-one in the end with the Tech-9. Had he got that, that could have been a nail in the coffin for Na'Vi, but they managed to claw out that situation. It was a great read for them at the start of the round as well. Cutler pushing for that information as we predicted. Got taken down, and they execute onto the site, but it was very messy in the end. But no force by response from CLG. We see full rifle setup coming from Na'Vi. This is a very wise decision on Cobble, especially. Keep the range nice and long, work the frags together, and make sure you stay as a team.
It's especially something we see from Na'Vi almost always as well. They've definitely started to make this their own thing, just going straight in. Full head armor. Good tag onto Seized, actually. I didn't see where it came from. That was over in towards B-site. Now, Hayes has actually got a couple of exchanges on towards Edward. Now, it's my Guardian. He's trying to pin him around the side, but Flamey will manage to get the opener as they push through straight up ramp. Hayes does get himself the kill on towards Edward. That was on long eight. And JDM, Tarek all moving in towards site while Flamey's trying to get himself up the ramp. Seized around the back will get himself an easy kill. Hayes, that was timing, if ever there was one. Guardian, though, in sight. Zeus has still got the bomb. He's all the way down in ramp at the moment. It's still... This is a very strange setup from Na'Vi. They've managed to get a control, and then yet still not gone for the plant. They want to get the kills.
Yeah, you can see Flamey has got control of the site, but they're just not sure where the CTs are lying right now. So they're just trying to flush out and make sure every possibility is covered before they commit the bomb to the site.
Well, it's going to be execution style on Hayes from the back there. Flamey's still been holding this angle for a long time. Seized, oh, little tap onto JDM there. Now Finesse, I believe they know his position. He's pinned in the corner. They're just going to wait for him to show. See if he can get one, but no, Flamey's not going to allow it. And it was an easy double for him in the end.
That was a very nice, methodical round, yeah. Abby. They like you said, they did have the A-side control, but they knew they didn't have information on the CT area, so they just wanted to make sure they covered everything. There's so much on the line right now. Even losing one gun is going to be devastating to their economy, so they just wanted to make sure they approached it, and they did it perfectly. So they go into this one. Interesting enough, Edward's got a Mac-10, right? So that suggests they may go towards drop-down and just see what's going on there, whether there is a stack going in, and what you were utilizing that. There's actually him going towards long A, so... I told you they favoured the A bomb site, and that's what they're going to keep trying to do, is pincering that area and trying to find the frags. But FNS boosted up. Could he cause some trouble here?
It's Caesar who's going to get around the back off, but unfortunately Caesar was ready and waiting because it is an A hit that Na'Vi are setting up for. Edward's the man that's creeping forward. He's going to get around the back of Cutler as well. Hayes is making himself known. Oh, Edward goes down though to Cutler in that exchange, and that gives him a Mac-10 to play with. Can Cutler make use of it as Hayes tries to keep them at bay? Tarek's caught the lurk around the back there. Caesar goes down. This is a 4-on-3 in CLG's favour. Now remember, they picked up the eco last time around in the third round of the half, and that was a sneaky little bit of bomb plant play. Tarek actually still making tracks. He's picked himself up the AK now, which is why Flame is going to have to delay.
Yeah, and now the CLG have the man advantage. They have the AK. Very difficult round, but they haven't got any advantage in the position yet. Hayes get taken down, and now they can make their way onto A.
They're pushing through. Tarek's making fast tracks, though. Look at Cutler. He's tucked away. He's waiting to burst around the side. He could get Zeus there, but Guardian will take him down. Tarek does manage to get himself on with his AK. Flamey around the corner. Will manage to catch out, but JDM gets the bomb planter. And now it's just him versus Flamey. 49 health, head armor. Tries to go to the challenge and gets the headshot down. And CLG pick up a round from absolutely nothing. All they had was pistols, and that was a full eco. That's a big devastating loss for Na'Vi.
Yep, absolutely. That's huge, and the CLG are going to be so happy that they played it so well as well, taking their first two initial kills, finding the weak men, and Na'Vi, they were isolated by themselves and falling back to the A site, forcing the T's to come in. Fantastic work from them, and you can see Na'Vi have a player. They have got a buy, but Zeus is going to be on the Tech 9. So we've got the AWP on JDM. This is looking very strong for them now. Let's see how Na'Vi can respond and get himself back into this.
They're going fast. Flame is going to try and push him straight through. He's got caught up though. Tried to flash out and go piling through onto platform. He has got out there. Now Tarek and JDM are watching this angle. And he's yet to be spotted. Tarek on boost where Flamey was previously. Flamey's all too aware of that position. JDM though will not miss the second chance of taking a shot. But Zeus has managed to open one up in drop room. That's forced him to go a little bit more passive here and maybe have to go for the retake as Guardian finds Cutler over on long A. He pushes around, lines up for Hayes, but doesn't come out on top in the duel. And now a 3-on-2. It's a retake situation for CLG. JDM trying to line up the shot, hoping he can land something because Seize gets that plant down. Smoke will cut them off from double doors, so it's going to have to be a delayed take, and I think they're going to have to choose wisely to save.
I think that's definitely the right decision there. Like, as soon as JDM lost his positional control in the B-bomb site, it's very difficult to retake that, especially with an AWP, and the smokes get dropped. You almost have zero chance there, and this is such a huge round for them in terms of economy, right? So they won the last round, but losing this one resets the money. They'll go into the next one with $1,400, so they're just banking on saving that AWP in the M4. I think this is a good decision from them, but the T's are aware. They're hunting. They want to find them. They know how big this is to save the AWP, so they'll be hunting flat out, trying to see whether they can find them. But JDM should be able to survive here. He's in a decent position towards long A, so nice round from Na'Vi to get back into that. I didn't see that one coming. I thought this could be the start of the momentum for CLG.
Well, let's see if his back and forth momentum continues, because we could have an absolute belter on our hands here. 10-9, CLG with the lead over Na'Vi after a 9-6 first half on the T side. Na'Vi respond after that eco. It's the best way to respond as well. And now you can see they have the full assortment, everything, while CLG are hurting for cash.
Yeah, absolutely. FNS has actually opted to put the thing he has into this round, so it's going to be a fast execution for Na'Vi, though, making their way towards B.
They're going to pull on straight through. Look at JDM. He's going to get boosted, I think. They're going to lump him up. He's going straight towards Edward. Oh, that could easily be a quick headshot on towards JDM, and he realizes he's in trouble. He's going to have to use that molly to try and back himself out, get himself in a better situation. They back away. Navi, that was a great flash, by the way. Caught five members there. Everybody caught out. Tarik not managing to get the spray down. JDM in trouble. Questionable positioning, maybe. I don't know. Zuka's going to get the plant down. And they say, try and push in. A pincer move. Backfires. And Navi will easily clear out sight and get the plant. And it's just, unfortunately, left down to Cutler and Hazed to try and save their weapons.
Yeah, unfortunately for CLG, they invested quite a lot into this round as well. You've got two players. It's going to be Tarik and FNS with next to nothing going. And they have $1,900 each from the loss bonus, but this is where it gets difficult for them. It's going to be 10-10. Navi definitely have the economic advantage here. This is where it starts slipping away from them, and some mistakes are starting to show.
Oh, Cutler, is he going to find Seized? He is, but unfortunately Seized will find him first. You've got to look towards that round and think very cleverly for Navi, more importantly, as they knew that JDM were that off that AWP. He's been over on B-site every time, and they just chose to straight rush on through, and caught him out completely.
The execution from them was perfect. Did you see how much he had a clear shot on the side, but the flashbangs were just non-stop. They just kept flying in. He couldn't even find himself in a position where he could actually get a kill, and then as soon as they did that, they swarmed him on the bomb site, and he was completely locked down. So, really nice, clever play from Navi. CLG have saved one M4, but this round, you have to almost guarantee in towards Navi. Look how slow they're taking it again. As long as they don't make a mistake like they did before, they should be able to get the 11th round on the board.
Yeah, let's not forget, they did get caught with that eco. But this time, we're not going to see a boost from FNS. Tarik's not going to be the man that lurks around the side. It is going to be very much tried and tested standard setup. And that will, of course, give a big advantage to Navi as they try and edge closer towards B-site. Edward lining up the smoke, so this is going to be potentially a bit of a fake, but Guardian gets the kill on Hayes nonetheless, and they'll turn them. JDM going down. This is all, as you would expect, going Navi's favour.
Yeah, they're just feeding out the map now, seeing where the CDs are, locating the stack, and they've opened it up very nicely. Cutler's going to be the last man with the M4, and he will go down as well. But let's have a look at the money now for the CTs. They can get a reasonable buy-in now. They definitely will be buying this. It won't be a full one, but Navi definitely know they're in the driving seat now. We talked about their comebacks and what a comeback has been so far. That's going to be one round so far for CLG, 5-1 on this half. So they're looking phenomenal right now. We have seen them favour towards the A side, but the B side execution seem flawless as well from Navi. So if they can keep this up, they've got a very strong chance of taking this map and getting back into it.
Let's see how they set up this one. Navi reset the clock. They have the lead for the first time in this match. And they will take a little peek towards the lead again. Just looking to see if they can get any tags, rattling that AK shots through the smoke, hoping that somebody is sitting on platforms. See if you see that little kill feed pop up that you managed to land your shots. Nothing being given. C's getting a little peek, a drop. Doesn't manage to catch a glimpse of FNS, who was lurking in wait. And they are going to slow it down. Edward and Guardian are on a fact-finding mission right now. They're pushing over on long A, so they're going to push around. That's going to give a little problem for Cutler and Hayes. They're going to try and see if they can force CLG to rotate, but they're holding steady.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it hasn't been too effective so far. Hasn't been enough pressure applied to sell that. So the CTs will stay strong at B, three of them remaining. Of course, they have JDM at the back, man. He's going to be the most important part of this.
Can he hit those shots? Seuss creeps on through. Oh, JDM had to open that one up. He will get the second chance, but Seized has already got one down and drop. That was FNS, and now JDM's position is very much known. That's a great little grenade cover. You can see they're just edging around. He doesn't manage. He's burning down in the corner. He will go down, but it's a good little spray from Tarik and Cutler to respond. Now, two members remain for both teams. Edward gets himself a quick, easy kill there. Hayes comes around, and the headshot's found, and Navi pick themselves up another. CLG starting to struggle on the CT side.
Huge round there from Navi. Great slow play. They're famous for it. Just holding the map as long as possible. Felt out the side. They didn't get any sort of contention there, so decided to opt towards B, but now the pause has come in. This definitely will be a tactical pause at this stage. They can feel this one slipping away from them, and you can see the money again. They're in a difficult position. We know the American seems like the force buy, but at around 3K, I really wouldn't be recommending it at this stage. It's getting pretty dangerous for them, and it's looking like Navi are back in the driver's seat, going to take it all the way. Look at the expressions, lost for words, it seems like, CLG right now.
Well, they've already picked up six rounds on the T side, Navi. Remember, it was a 9-6 first half for CLG. And they're going to have to equal that or better to try and take their way back into this one. Hazed on your screen there, bottom of the scoreboard for CLG right now. I know certainly was actually, I had a good chat with him just after the last matchup, and he felt he'd actually almost lost that match against Yves Bethel. I think it was the 27th round. Yeah, the tactic was to, for him and Tarek to push through Kat and then not get seen, but they got spotted. They backed away, and then Yves Bethel basically had a perfect setup and massacred them. That was when he went to 14-12. Sure. He himself was carrying that load, so maybe coming into this one still not quite there mentally. I don't know.
Well, this seems like another game that's going to go into the history of CLG of almost but not quite enough.
Oh, yeah.
They've got the 10 rounds on the board, but now they're going to be looking like they're going into an eco. You can see the CZ buy from FNS there, but they won't be forcing this one. They'll be looking to play the long game, but ultimately this pits Navi onto 13-10, and they're looking so strong right now. Their slow play is just picking apart CLG so much. They just don't seem to have a response there. We saw JDM miss the first shot there, give away his position, got molotoved out. He didn't even have a chance to get back into the round at that point. He just got burnt alive at the back of the chicken coop there, but Navi, the tactical prowess they've got right now, it's so strong, and they're one of my favorite teams to watch just in terms of their way they can read the game and pick apart CTs.
I would say, looking at CLG, they seem to have cool, calm comms now, which is something, you know, obviously was talked about, I'm thinking like 6 months ago, everybody would talk about how chaotic American comms were. That's something they definitely had to learn from the European teams.
Sure.
I distinctly remember Devil Walk listening in on certain teams and thinking, how on earth do they play like that? Because obviously the Swedes are so used to being so calm. And well, focus faces for CLG, ready and waiting to go. It will be an eco for them, as you mentioned, just that CZ75 being picked up. They did manage to close out a CZ round before, but this time they're going to stack, they're going to boost, they're going to try and launch themselves up there, but CZ is ready and waiting. You can't trick them twice.
See Guardian actually up in the sniper tower as well. We haven't seen that position in about 5 years, but he's making it work for himself. Gets a pick into Cutler, and this is a great round from Navi. Nice quick stuff. And the last two players will be in drop down. CZ, I was going to say, should make light work for them, but gets taken down by JDM, and it's a 4-2 now, but these guys don't have many options here.
Yeah, they're going to try and boost. It looks like launch Tarek's through. No, he just had a little glimpse, but Zeus, it bought him time to come around and look. Flamey saw JDM's back there as he tried to get escape through window. He's just going to try and buy himself some time in the smoke. He's got a knife out, actually. He's ready to cut someone if they come through. It's not going to work out for him, though. Flamey will close it out. So an expected round there, but this is the one that counts now for CLG. They're going to have rifles, and they're going to have basically their last chance, their last roll of the dice here, I feel, or Navi will close the game out.
I'd like to see JDM move his position. The chicken coop just isn't working out for him. He's not being impactful enough there and shutting it down. The Navi know, have got his number here. I'd like to see him see what Guardian does. Get down to middle, perhaps. Get some early information, and then they can base their players off that. But it seems like he will be opting for a very similar setup. T-side opting to go towards B again, but I wouldn't be surprised if they keep the thing slow here. It's working out very well for them.
Smoke will go down, as always. Seems actually boosting Flamey up. Guardian also being boosted up. It's a double weird boost coming out from Navi here. Guardian trying to get a little glimpse on towards that platform, but nobody's there. Luckily this time, JDM's going towards that position. He's about to go in towards that boost that Guardian was looking straight towards. Guardian lining up the shot. They're both going to get the little peek. Oh. It's JDM that will count. It's actually the lowest stack, and Guardian goes down. JDM with a quick double, and that may well have just turned this game on its head. Navi, two men down, and suddenly wondering what the hell just hit him.
I believe you got those two frags. Amazing stuff from him. Flame is going to find some contention, but Tarek takes him down as well, and all of a sudden it's a 5-on-2 situation with CLG. Maybe that pause has got them back into the game. JDM showing some aggression and utilizing it well as he gets them right back into this, and it's going to be 13-11, and Navi need to decide now, do they go for this? He's going to be the AWP trying to find a pick himself.
Trying to peek around JDM, you can see him in the x-ray lining up the shot, manages to make it a third, and Edward, the last man standing, 24 seconds on the board, he's going to rotate around and force them to take a peek, and that's all that Tarek needed. A clean round, more importantly for CLG, their economy was in tatters before that. That was literally last roll of the dice. And well, when your AWP lands three very important kills, that is exactly what you want.
Stellar play from JDM. I was saying before, the chicken coop wasn't working for him. He's allowing Navi to have too much control of the upper platform area. As soon as he changed his position up, he got up there, and taking down two players as they're stacking like that, that's phenomenal from him. And it's going to be a great morale boost for CLG going into this next round.
Of course, Navi can afford to buy straight back up, and this time they're going to challenge out over towards A site. Guardian actually at long A. Hayes and Cutler, the only two that are over there. A lot of nades back and forward on B site, but it is just a full-on fake. Now, I feel that CLG are kind of expecting something here. You can see they've boosted Cutler into a good little spot. They haven't used this yet, but it is a relatively standard spot. Now, Guardian going to land the shot. Doesn't manage to make it. Count for Hayes there. And Cutler does manage to get one. Can he get a second? Zeus is going to be the man that peeks. He gets the pistol. Switches in, goes a little aggressive. He's going to get the support as well. And the molly. How the hell is Cutler still alive? Flamey's coming around the back of him. He will manage to cut him out. But that's just about all the information that CLG needed.
Hayes threw him under the bus there as well. He didn't even come in like contend for it when that guy's in a 3-on-1 situation. So he's going to be annoyed at that, I think, Cutler, to some extent. 4-on-4 now does favor Navi. So this is next frag is huge for them. Let's see how they go into this round.
Zeus flashes himself in, rushes straight through into double doors, but Finesse heard that, and they're actually coming from the both angles. That was a beautiful shot, but he will get responded, and now it's going to be a 3-on-3. Navi making the move. They're going to be rushing through platform. Tarik is the man. JDM just about to get into position. Tarik holding the fountain, gets a shot on Guardian. He's the ball passer. Flamey now lined up. Finesse gets him down. Flamey is dropped, and CLG are right back in it.
Yeah, absolutely. That side alley contention there. When Cutler was up in that boosted area, absolute pandemonium kicked off, and he managed to make it work for him, getting one frag. I think they could have made that a lot more advantageous for them, but it doesn't matter at this stage. 13-12, they keep applying the pressure to Navi, and that's now two in a row. Great stuff from CLG. They're actually being able to respond to what they're bringing to the table, but of course, Navi winning so many rounds in a row, their economy is not affected too badly. We can see there's not a lot of utility for Flamey and Seize, though, so perhaps the slow rounds won't pay off them so much. They have to rely more on the frags, but importantly, Guardian still does have that AWP, so he's going to be opting to go towards the middle area now.
CLG seemingly were expecting potentially like some sort of Tech 9 force rush through there. They were force stacked on B site, ready and waiting, heavily around drop, but they've rotated back into position. I think Hayes maybe has caught a glimpse of something. Cutler's got himself back at the APC as well. You can see four man from Navi already to make this move on a Guardian. Once again, a pivotal player for Navi, looking to try and get this open on Hayes. Slowly they work towards. JDM has full vision right now. He has a complete eye on Bean, which is why we're seeing a three-man rotate from CLG. They're on A site now, set up. Zeus and Edward are going to be bursting out along. Flamey coming round. Guardian's going to pick at a peek. Hayes gets the shot down, and that's the bomb carrier. The quick counter flash. Is he going to go for a second check? Is he going to buy himself some time? The flash doesn't work out for him, and Flamey will get dropped by Tarik. This could well be a 13-13 as CLG closed down. Seize don't round the back with Edward. Edward might be able to recover the bomb here, but Seize will get taken down. He's going to recover it, but he's on a 4-on-1 with just 20 seconds. He can't get this plant down. There's not a chance, and there's a tactical timeout coming out from Navi.
Yep.
It's going to be 13-13, ladies and gentlemen. CLG once again taking it to one of the top five teams of the world. Question is, can they close it out this time around?
This is so exciting, and that's actually a really nice play from CLG. We know Navi likes to play the timer down, but that was brilliantly read from CLG. Great synergy as well in the middle area, utilizing the team play. Flash coming through, Hayes picking up the initial frag. In most situations, I'd have advised him to fall back there, but he thought, I'm going for more, I'm guaranteeing us this round. Takes down two more, and that was a sensational play from them. Takes it to 13-13 now, and it's actually going to put Navi in a very difficult position now. They're actually the ones with the economic deficit. What do they do? They've got one AK here on Edward, but ultimately he's actually force bought that one. So was that a buy before they decided what to do? The rest of the guys are on about $2,500.
Yeah, that's forcing the hand of Zeus, because now that if they don't win this round, they're on match point. And, you know, economically, next round, they could be in trouble if they do not win this round now.
I think so. They've got the loss bonus in their favor, but them buying this round puts them in a very strange place next time. So this is all or nothing now. If CLG take this one, they could be in a very strong position going into the final few rounds, but can't take anything away from CLG. They really are reading the slow play now, reacting to it, and making sure they don't allow Navi to execute onto the site. They're locking it down before it happens, and that's what you need to do. You can't allow Navi to have full roam and get Guardian picks, for example. So this has been perfect for them, and that pause seemed to have paid dividends for them, as they're actually playing very well now and reacting perfectly.
Tarik and JDM, top of the board, 26 kills, 23 for Flamey. Really, the players that needed to perform are performing for both teams. It's just the rest of the guys that need to catch up with them. It is a very close matchup. at 13-10, we were so expecting something, just something, to get through. Of course, Edward didn't flop by. Of course, he saved it from the previous round, yeah.
So he saved it, so that's why he hasn't got any money going for this round. But the rest of the guys now, they are doing the force buy with it. So still, the same result comes in. They have got enough of the loss bonus to justify this. So PT-50s in armor there. Smokes and flashbangs coming in. So when they're going to beat this round, will be a very fast drop down push. It looks like all five players now going to that side of the map.
But COG are ready for it. They've got two drop ready and waiting. They're expecting something quick to come through. Tarik set himself up on platform. Going to get himself in the corner. This is a normal spot that Flamey actually plays. I've seen him here a lot of times. Not to great success, I've got to be honest. Cutler, you can see the second that smoke clears, he will have a shot lined up on Flamey. Just as he backs away, as it dissipates. Audible tension from both teams here. As Tarik gets a little glimpse across there, gets tagged up heavily. Flash onto JDM, that's going to cause him problems, and Flamey will get the opener. Tarik also taken down, but JDM, once again in chicken coop, manages to respond while the rest of his team get in position. He's also got out of the corner, which is so important. The bomb being tossed up to Zeus. I think he's going to try the rotate. I think he's going to run its way. He is! He's off! He's running! The rest of the team, no, he's actually going back to B. He's decided to pass it back. No, he's just wanted to pass it back, but JDM lands the shot on Guardian. Edward just 10 health. JDM switches to the 5-7. Haste has rotated back. He's so worried about this. And seized in drop room in position. Haste is going to come through window, so he's got to be careful. They're set up ready and waiting. They have to hit this perfectly. They've got no flashes, no smokes, everything. There's the one single smoke they had, which has gone out. That's going to cut off Haze. And now it's all on JDM and Cutler. There's JDM. Gets himself the third of the round. Makes it a fourth. Could he finish the eighth? It doesn't matter. Cutler strikes. And that is CLG with the lead once again at 14-13.
Navi going into the bomb site, getting two entry kills there. We thought that was all tied up. I'm not sure why this didn't swarm JDM in that stage. They allowed him to get one shot there, reset, and then find his position again, and he answers back with three huge kills there. So amazing stuff from him, and of course that takes him to 14-13. Look at the buy now from the T side. Galil's out. They have got a decent amount of equipment there, but this is getting so exciting. Every round so back and forth and bringing something new to the table.
So low on utility, they have to either go fast and hope something works or just slow it right down. And now Cutler and FNS sitting at drop, expecting something, like lions waiting for their prey to drop down towards them, and it's just a molly to get things a little toasty down there. Guardian actually so low play right now over on A side. Hasty's going to be there, but it's JDM getting himself in it. Bit of an awkward position, actually. He's got to back away from this one. The grenade will land, but is it going to be enough? Edward's quickly through on platform. Flamey comes around. That's going to be a flying Edward, but he doesn't come out on top. It's Tarik that will get the kill, but it's quickly answered by Flamey with a second. Now he's going to push on through. Doesn't manage to get the lineup on Vanessa. Now they're in trouble, but Seize will get a quick response. To 2-on-2. Finesse insight. Haze completely smoked out. Haze will get the kill. Zeus, the only man with bomb, gets a clean shot on towards Vanessa. A 1-on-1. Haze having to push on through doors. Zeus is going to go for the plant here. It's going to buy Haze time to get in towards drop room and line up the angle. M4 versus Galil. Both around the same hit points. Zeus just got a glimpse of the Haze back there. He knows his position. He's got nothing to play with. Haze has still got two flashes. Yet to throw one out, though. And Zeus is going to be just playing this one perfectly. The time is working in Zeus's favor as he goes for the foot race around the side and gets hazed in the back. We're all square once again at 14-14.
What a game this is turning out to be. Navi finding a round out of absolutely nowhere. And that one-on-one situation could have gone either way. Had they won that, there would have been a match point and Navi down to absolutely nothing in terms of money. But they get themselves to 14-14. And you can see CLG going to be very disappointed that round. That was one. They could have just ended it there and then. But no, Navi answered back, and they are again on the force by here. Next to nothing again, the Galil will be out, but they have got an M4 in hand. But how is this one going to end? It could be going to overtime at this stage, but here we go. Another fast play towards the B area.
Jamie's going to be pushing on too quick. Does get slowed down. That smoke and flash perfectly timed there. And let remind you, ladies and gentlemen, this is for a place in the quarterfinals versus Emius. The loser will be out of the tournament. That is how close and how much is on the line. Everybody wants to be playing in that Lanxess Arena tomorrow morning, and at the moment one of these two teams will be doing that, but one will be going home a very unhappy man. It's going to be an A hit. You can see them stacking up here. Navi, hey, Hayes was in a perfect spot last time around to catch them out, but this time he's going to get challenged. A flash is not going to come. He's going to line another shot, but he doesn't manage to land it. That's so big. Cutler caught in no man's land. They have control of A-side.
Such a difficult retake now. Look at this setup. They've still got smokes to lock it down. And here they come, the CTs now. Can they do anything to get back into this round? It's so vital they find a kill.
I think they have to save the rifles. They have to back away. They have to try and take it to match point. C's, though.
Such a shame.
Still sitting around drop point. This is going to take it match point for Na'Vi. Now C's could pick up some big kills here. Look at Tarik not looking. He's going to walk on straight through. Now JDM lines it up. He will save the AWP. For now, Edward and Flamey are on the hunt. They're coming around the back and they may just catch him. Finesse being cut off from his team here. JDM's going to get himself right back into T-spawn. Finesse, though, not going to keep hold of it. And if they get JDM's AWP, this is going to be a tragedy for CLG. Money-wise, they are going to be in so much trouble. They will have nothing in this final round. JDM has to land the shot, but Flamey gets it. And that may just be the match-winning shot for Flamey as Na'Vi go match point and CLG are broke.
Absolutely. That was so important. They saved those guns. Once they lost the A-bomb site there, they needed to make sure they kept the AWP and the rifles just to have even a chance going into this final round now. But the fact Na'Vi knew that, they hunted the dome, found them in T-spawn, and now they know how much control they have this time. Only pistols to save CLG at match point here. This could be a make or break for them right now.
Almost 60 kills between Tarik and JDM, but unfortunately for them, it may not be. Once again, CLG so close, but yet so far. The story very much for the last 2 weeks of CLG is very telling here. Na'Vi, boy, have they had to work for it. CLG just trying anything, stacking out, but look at the patience that Na'Vi have. They pretty much well aware of the fact that this is a very broke CLG they're up against, but they're not taking any risks. They have been caught out by these pistols before, and Tarik with that 5-7 is going to be so vital. He has to land the opening shot. Finesse is going to line it up. Guardian's going to peek. He gets a glimpse, but he misses the shot. But that may well just be it, but Tarik responds, gets himself one, but Zeus is quick to draw, and Flayness and Tarik will go down. JDM, Hazed and Cutler is all that stands in the way of Na'Vi securing themselves his quarterfinal spot. Now it's just one man. It is Cutler, the in-game leader. He can't do anything. It is Na'Vi that will face Envious tomorrow in the quarterfinals. Once again, it is such a sad, sad story for CLG fans. So close, but yet so far.